Hey guys, welcome in to our week 17 builder in BRL. We are up against Zio, who is the coach of the Blazing Blazikins. Now, before you all freak out saying, where's week 6? Unfortunately, my opponent Cloud had some... I got sick at the start of the week, so I couldn't battle at our scheduled time, and then we rescheduled to Sunday, and unfortunately he had some personal issue occur like relatively quickly, so he could not battle. So as unfortunate as it is, he did give me the forfeit win. I would still like to battle Cloud at some point. I think we both agreed to do like a non-official battle to see what would have happened with some heat sets. So yeah, going into this week we are 6-0, positive 17. So we're guaranteed playoffs, but I'm still going into these last few weeks because I want to finish first. I want to finish in first place so we guarantee go to semifinals. Because first place gets an automatic bye to semifinals. We don't have to play quarterfinals, which is really good. So, Zio has a dangerous team. And Greninja, Salamence, Nidoking, Mega Charizard Y, Aegislash, Miss Magius, the Blade, Decidueye, Pikachu, Kling Klang, and Weirdare, with his terrors being Miss Magius, the Blade, and Pikachu. Now, the thing about Zio is that he's brought his first 6 Mons to every single battle, except he's brought the Blade instead of Aegislash to one of them. He hasn't brought Decidueye, Pikachu, Kling Klang, or Weirdare to any of his battles so far. He has rocked the first 6. So yeah, it is kind of predictable what he's going to bring. Like, I'm pretty sure he's going to bring an Assault Fist Nidoking, because he has quite a few weeks, a Scarf Mints, I can see, once again. He's kind of brought the same sets almost every week. So, yeah. Let's go over our team. And as you guys notice, I'll get to it in a second. First up, we have Taco Tuesday or Jolteon, Honla Flame Orb with Quick Feet, with Thunderbolt, Terror Blast, Volt Switch, and Protect. 64 in HP, 252 in Special Attack, 192 in Speed. With a Timid Nature, we are Terra Ice this week, because Terra Ice obliterates this team. Terra Ice, Jolteon, 1v1's Greninja, Mint, Nidoking, Charizard. Like a 1v1 says 4. And we Volt Switch out on Miss Magius and Aegislash if we need to. I decided to rock Protect this week over Shadow Ball. Just to like scout the Greninja set, scout the Nidoking set as well. That was the main thing. Because Nidoking, in my opinion, is the biggest threat on this team. To my team, Nidoking is the biggest threat. So if we can just chip a few Mons down a little, Taco Tuesday or Jolteon can come in and just clean up. Now you might be wondering why this cow is on my screen. As transactions end this week, so any transactions that people want to make, they have to do it by the end of this week, because teams are locked at the beginning of week 8. So, I had a look at the rest of my matches, and I'll be honest, Comfey just isn't doing anything in them. I was going to bring Comfey for mine and Cloud's game, and it was its first time going to show up, and probably its only time it will ever show up. And I've used Terra Miltank in my own league for 3 weeks, and I've been bloody loving Terra Miltank. It's honestly one of my favorite low tier terrors now, and it's become that really quickly because it's bulky. So anyway, we have PTSD. If you get the reference, you know the reference. The mill tank on the left overs with thick fat, with body slam, rock slide, milk drink, and stealth rock. 248 in HP, 8 in attack, 252 in special defense with a careful nature. This is my Zard chick. Oh, and just in case shit goes sideways, we are Terra Water. Just in case shit goes sideways. Oh yeah, because I transferred Comface Terra to Mill Tank. Because you drop a Terra Mon, and the Mon you pick up automatically it transfers the Terra. Fun fact. This Mill Tank without Terra takes 33, I think it's 33% max from Mega Zard Y and Sun. Body Slam Rock Slide hits his entire team, barring Aegislash. We don't really care, this is not our Aegislash answer. Stealth Rock is there just to help us ship things down if we need to. Milk Drink for longevity. This can also help with Greninja. This can also help with Nidoking if it's special. Miss Magius. Specially defensive Mill Tank kind of eats. Because that's the thing about his team. Most of his threats are special attackers. Up next we have Thunder Thighs, our Mega Medicham. Our team captain holding the Medicham. With pure power, with Zen Headbutt, Fire Punch, Trailblazing, Fake Out, 4 on HP, 252 in attack, 252 in speed with a jolly nature. We have to be max speed to speed time mints. That's it. That's really it. We're not a fighting move this week because the only thing I need a fighting move for is Greninja, which we have Trailblaze for. Now I'm to my thing about moves that don't have 100% accuracy. I don't run them unless there are rolls that kill. Zen Headbutt, after a fake out from Mega Medicham, 2 mints, has a chance to kill. Psycho Cut does not. That's why we are running Zen Headbutt this week. Fire Punch for Aegislash, and in Sun, nothing wants to switch into a Fire Punch from a Mega Midi in Sun. Even Greninja is taking like 44%. And Fake Out just to help us out. So it's a little odd Mega Midi set that. Yeah, it's a little bit of an odd one. You see no fighting move, but we don't need it. Up next, also coming off the bench, is Chernobyl, a Weezing on the Black Sludge with Levitate with a Return, Payback, Will-O-Wisp, and Pain Split. Yes, you see that moveset. It is a no-stab Weezing. With 248 in HP, 8 in attack, 252 in special defense with a careful nature. Once again, this is my main Dino check. Because with Levitate, he can't hit us with ground moves. We resist Sludge Wave and Thunderbolt. And like Ice Beam is doing like 30 to 40%. Which is really good. You may be wondering, why are you running this set? Well, Return hits everything on his team, barring his Ghost types. And I was doing calcs against Aegislash Shield Form. Fun fact, Payback to Shield Form Aegislash does more than Flamethrower or Fire Blast. So that's why we're running Payback, and it also doubles in damage. If the user switches out, or if we move last. So that is our plan there. Will-O-Wisp to try and hopefully this Aegislash is physical, so we can Wisp it. We can also try Wisp Mints as well. And Pain Split, Longevity. Yeah. Up next we have Monkey Business, our Ambipom home, the Silk Scalped Technician with Double Edge, Knockoff, Triple Axel, and Fake Out. 80 in HP, 252 in attack, 176 in speed with a jolly nature. Outspeeds his whole team other than Greninja. Once again, other than his ghost types, this is a free double-edged fake-out game from Ambipom. Yeah, that's really it. Triple Axles here for Nidoking, for Mint, knockoff for these ghost types. Last but not least, we have Excalibur, our Corviknight on the leftovers with Pressure, with Brave Bird, U-Turn, Roost, and Tailwind. 248 in HP, 8 in attack, 252 in special defense with a careful nature. You may be wondering, I'm running, yes, 3 special walls this week, because I need 3 special walls, because all his threats in my 8, all his threats that can actually deal damage to me are special attackers, right? Other than Mints, but I can deal with Mints between this and this. So it's fine. Brave Bird, U-turn, try and pivot out of Nidoking, do a shit ton of damage to Nidoking. Roost, longevity. Tailwind is to try and get Mega Medi or Jolteon to go ham. Or even Ampipom. We have 3 breakers this week in these 3. And 3 special walls to help them out to take hits. But yeah, that is the battle, everyone. I'll see you all shortly. Alrighty, guys. We are here for the battle. And I do want to apologize now. As this is not a live recording of the battle. The day the battle happened. So I'm recording this later at night of the day the battle happened. I literally just got home from being in a 7-hour car ride. And I did not feel like doing a live recording. That's really it. But we're here. You still get the battle. You still get you get a different form of the voiceover, because I can actually talk you through my thoughts properly. But yeah, let's get into the battle. He did bring the exact 6 that I thought he would bring, because he just brought these 6, like I said in Team Builder, every week. Now, if he leads, so let's go over this. So I led Ampipom, because Ampipom is a free lead. If he leads Aegislash or Miss Magius, we just switch out. Simple as that. We go Corv if he goes to either of these, right? But knowing that we sent out first, we are faster than what he brings out. So he leads Zard and he immediately megas it. We click fake out and do 45%, which is good for us. And then here, I decide to just click double edge, right? Double edge, we Oko, Zard is gone, one of his big threats is already dead turn 2. I double edge here instead of going for knockoff to try to predict the ghost type, because even if he does go into a ghost type, I lose nothing by clicking double edge, right? It's either I kill the Zard, do no damage, and I switch out. Like, in my opinion, double edging there is the right option. And it worked out. So we see that, he brings up Mints now. And here, he reveals he is Scarfed. He is a Scarfed Mint, so he is Scarfed Moxie as well. Because he's not Intimidate. So he reveals he is Scarfed. We live on 8 because of our 80 HP investment. We live on 8. And we click Triple Axel here, killing the Mints with Ampipom with 2 frags. So it's a great showing from Ampipom. And here, I just decide to knock and sack off Ampipom to weaken this Aegislash and get rid of its lefties, which is good. And he does reveal he is physical. which is good for us. I decided to go hard wheezing here, to wisp it. Even if he switches out while wisping something. Psycho Cut, we land the wisp, which is good. I did not know this thing got Psycho Cut. It did catch me by surprise a little. So now this thing is burnt, and I didn't realize this till, like, now watching this back, and it even shows in the, thing here. We're using 60 speed, /60 speed. We are speed tied. I didn't realize that. So I should have been a minor speed nature, so payback always, we always go second, and we would have killed Aegis Slasher. But he goes for another Psycho Cut. He dies to burn on this next turn coming up. So I'm just going to preserve my Weezing HP, and I'm going to hard switch to Core, predicting he goes for King Shield, which he does, because then if we hit him, we take damage. So he dies to burn. Weezing picks up a frag as well, his debut, doing well. I stay in here and I calc that flamethrower does about 55% max if he is life orb sheer force. So I stay in and I click Brave Bird. Brave Bird does 52%, so I'm like, sweet, I lose nothing here. Him doing 49 reveals that he is not life orbed. I believe he is AV. So I hard switch to Miltank. On another flamethrower, as we are thick fat. Because right now, Miltank is my most expendable one. Because Miltank's only job here was to deal with Megazard Y. So I lose nothing by clicking Body Slam. He, for some reason, goes into Greninja here and not Miss Magius. He reveals he is Protean and Life Orbed, which he has brought Protean Life Orb every week. Body Slam, we get the para, which is great for us. I just click Rock Slide here just in case he goes Miss Magius. I lose nothing by doing this. And Miltank also picks up a frag on her debut. So here I go Weezing to scout what he wants to do. We live the roll of Thunderbolt and we click Payback doing 83%. Now, in this moment in time, I'm just like, I could sack Weezing here, get a free switch in, you know, all this good stuff. However, for me to stay in first place, right, I'm the only undefeated team, for me to stay in first place, I need to keep differential, and I need to win, right? There are two people under me who are 5-1 going into this week, which is super scary. So I need to keep differential in case I do lose one and it does come down to differential diff. So I keep Weezing alive, go into Jolteon on a Thunderbolt. We have Burn, so we have Quick Feet. We Thunderbolt, kill them with Smagius. And we just Terrorize Terror Blast, because even if it's AV, it does 66% minimum. And that is the game. Granted, I probably could have preserved Ambipom and gone for the 6-0. It would require a little bit more positioning. But yeah, that is the battle, guys. We are now 7-0, positive 22, which is the best record I've ever gotten. Like, NPBA was, I think it was 6-3, positive 15. Was my final record. We're now 7-0, positive 22. So we've already bit my MPBA record, which is fucking amazing. Anyway, guys, yeah, so transactions are locked. We have no more transactions. So this team of 11 that you see, Megumidi, Samurott Hisuian, Corviknight, Terra Jolteon, Terra Miltank, Hydrapple, Ampipom, Weezing, Magmar, Tatsugaru, and Runerigus. That is our team going into the rest of the league, going into playoffs. We are guaranteed playoffs. It's just that I want to get first place. But yeah, that is the team, guys. If you guys enjoyed the video, hit that like button down below. Subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll catch you guys next time. Till then, stay safe, be yourself, and peace.